Hi, my name is Segaman.
I'm Sabata Matsumoto.
And I'm Saul Schleimer.
Go Maths!
If you've ever played with rainbow looms, or hair ties, or rubber bands, you may have run into this problem. You've made a chain of loops, and now you'd like to join the ends together to make a bracelet.
But how? Of course, you could use an S-clip or a carabiner. Or you could cut one of the bands and use it to tie a knot. But since we are topologists, these are all sort of cheating.
Here's the problem. We want to make a bracelet that stays on your arm and does not fall off. To be a bracelet, it must pass what we are calling the bracelet test.
I put the bracelet on my arm, and I clasp my hands.
If someone else can take it away, then it fails the bracelet test.
Let's find out if this passes the bracelet test.
Nope, not a bracelet.
Here are some more non-bracelets. Okay, so the chain itself needs to form a loop.
Here's something that passes the bracelet test. There's no way to take this bracelet off.
Showing that something cannot be done is often harder than showing that something can be done. You have to somehow check that none of the infinitely many things you might try works.
We will say more about proving this kind of thing at the end of the video. But this chain is sort of cheating anyway. The bracelet is made of loops, but you cannot make this bracelet out of hair ties without cutting and rejoining.
Okay, how about this? So this seems to pass the bracelet test. Again, this needs a proof.
New rule, no cutting is allowed. That is definitely cutting. No.
Here's another bracelet that passes the bracelet test. Incidentally, these two ties, together with Saul's arms, form the Boromian rings.
There's a problem with the Boromian rings bracelet, though. It's a bit tight. It is exactly as tight as a single hair tie, since each hair tie doubles back on itself.
So new, harder problem. Can you make a bracelet out of very small loops, like these?
This question was asked by Anton Petrunin on Math Overflow. He asked, my suitcase broke, but I have a ton of hair ties. Can I make sure my suitcase stays closed using only hair ties? Obviously, the one or two loop bracelets we saw before wouldn't work to go around a suitcase.
This feels like a knot theory question, but the length of the hair ties compared with the size of the suitcase makes it not quite topological. If you want to think about this for yourself, now is the time to pause the video and let us know your solution in the comments below.
Here's another way to think about it. Whatever shape you make with your loops, it must hold together when your arm is there, but completely fall apart when your arm isn't there. Because without your arm there, you can just reverse the video of you making the bracelet back to when they were just individual, separate hair ties.
We tried to prove that it's impossible to make a bigger bracelet for a couple of weeks before giving up. And it's a good thing that we did, because there are solutions discovered by Michael Friedman and Larson Linoff.
Here's what you do. First, make a chain, for example, using fishtails or square knots. The chain needs to be long enough to go twice around your arm. Next, make a slip knot on one end. And then make a slip knot on the other end. Enlarge the circles until they meet in the middle. Now, put your arm through both loops, and this passes the bracelet test.
It seems pretty secure, but we should prove that it passes the bracelet test.
We'll actually prove a stronger result, that even with infinitely stretchy topological bands, you cannot remove this bracelet.
The first step of the proof is to transform the person with clasped hands into a topologically identical object, a hair tie. It's a different color, red, to signify its special status. Now the person has been turned into a hair tie, we can treat them more like the other hair ties. In fact, they're the same as all of the other hair ties. By the way, we made this prop by cutting, then rejoining the red hair tie. We used a candle to melt it back together. This is definitely against the topological rules. Unfortunately, to really understand the rest of the proof requires a graduate course in geometric topology, plus a bit more. You have been warned.
Here in the appendix, we'd like to explain why this can't be taken apart into its component hair ties without cutting. Maybe this one is the human and the others are nicely symmetrically arranged. And you see that once the human's been turned into a hair tie, there's an extra symmetry, which wasn't visible before. There's this rotation symmetry around the center. So I'm going to call this thing a link of unknots. And we need to prove that it can't be moved into the unlink. It can't be separated. You can't pull the pieces off without cutting. So that's a theorem. The link, Ln, is not the unlink, which is a fancy name for the pile of hair ties all separated from each other. In fact, we're going to prove more. The complement, let's call that Xn, which is S3 minus Ln, is hyperbolic. So the complement of the unlink is very much not hyperbolic. So this second sentence is sort of a stronger version of the first sentence. So the first thing to do is to augment. We augment Ln by the symmetry axis. Let me call that Kn to obtain. Let me call Ln prime. So let me draw a picture of this. And what I'm going to do is, remember, the symmetry axis is around here. So I'm going to take this thing, which is coming kind of out and around, and I'm going to bend it off a little bit off to the side so that we can see it. There's a picture of Kn. And let me label it Kn. And remember that the white stuff, the original stuff, was Ln. So the union of the two together is Ln prime. We also need to define Xn prime equal to S3 minus Ln prime. So the complement, the thing that the knot is not, that gets smaller as the link gets bigger. So we had the link Ln, we added something to it. That's the same thing as drilling out a curve from Xn, and that gives us Xn prime. So Xn prime is obtained from Xn by drilling. So this link with the added component still has the symmetry, and it has something you can do. You can kind of take covers by unwrapping copies of Ln, and Kn just becomes, in some sense, it's a bigger unknot. Note that xln prime covers L fold xn prime. In particular, we have that xn prime covers n fold x1 prime. Recall, x1 prime equals S3 minus L1 prime. So I have a picture of that here. If we only had one link in our chain, then it would be a single hair tie, which is kind of clasping itself. The white stuff is the hair tie, but we still have the augmentation, which is now called K1, because there's only one link in our chain. So the important point about this is the following. We use a computer program, namely SnapP. X1 prime is hyperbolic. And the meridian of K1 has length exactly 5. So what's the meridian? The meridian is the curve, which is going around here. It's kind of dual to K1, and it's sort of measuring how far around the manifold goes. And when I take a cover, the meridian of Kn in Xn prime has length 5 times n. And maybe the important thing here is that if n is large, then 5n is 5 times larger. So now we're going to state the 2π theorem, which is due to Gromov and Thurston. If you fill along a curve of length greater than or equal to 2π, then the result is Pinch-Negerli curved. So maybe I should back up a step. I claimed that this manifold, X1 prime, is hyperbolic, and the meridian has a certain length. And I said, we're going to use a computer program to verify that. So this can be done with interval arithmetic. So that's a theorem. And then I said, okay, there's this 2π theorem of Gromov and Thurston. And what we're doing is, if you fill along a curve, so filling a curve, adding something to the complement means just taking this and erasing it, right? So if we went back to the link Ln prime and deleted Kn, that's the same thing as filling. So what we learn from all this is, thus, Xn admits symmetric of negative curvature. So then by a result of Thurston, Xn is hyperbolic. Both if 5 times n is greater than or equal to 2 pi. That is, if n is greater than or equal to 2. Finally, x1 is not hyperbolic. And that's because if you look at L1 all by itself, you can see that it is a connex sum of a pair of trefoils. So that's not hyperbolic. So this is the final result. We get exactly what we needed, that all of the links Ln when n is greater than or equal to 2 are hyperbolic, so they can't come apart. And actually the link L1, it also can't come apart because, well, it's only got one component, but it's a connex sum of trefoils. It's not the unknot. There are a few other links which we need to prove are non-trivial. The first of these is the Hopf link. This comes about when we have one of them being a hair tie and the other one being the human. One proof that this is non-trivial uses linking numbers, which is due to Gauss. The next link we need to prove is non-trivial is the bromine rings. And here, one of the components was the human and the other two were the bracelet. So you can prove that this is non-trivial using hyperbolic geometry. That's a quite different proof from the one before, or using sort of a higher order linking numbers called Milner invariants, due to Milner. And I think the last example is the metal chain. So the big component here is the human, and then these are linked to each other. So you could use hyperbolic geometry, very similar to the previous discussion, or you could use linking numbers to prove that this is non-trivial. Thanks for watching.